But I will not be telling the name of the chapter. You have to judge it. That means you have to find the name of the chapter by yourself, right? And it's not that much hard. It's very easy only, right? Say students, I have drawn something like this. This will give you the hint that which chapter actually we are going to start. These are some dots, right? And I have connected four dots and I have made this shape. So you must have seen this kind of shape in your life, right? And I know that you know the name also. The name of this shape is square, right, students? So today we'll be starting with a new chapter, that is chapter number 3. How many squares? Chapter 3. How many squares? Right, students, this is the name of the chapter, that is how many squares. Okay, students, now we are beginning with the page number 34, right? This is what you can see in your textbook also, that means your fifth standard textbook also, right? Now, if you can see, students, the dots are been there, right? And we need to connect the dots and we need to make some different shape, right? So here there is a first question that is given to us, that is measure the side of the red square. Red square, that means we need to measure that this red square on the dotted sheet, right? That means we have to measure the side of this red square. See students, if you measure this side, right, no need to use the scale, but justly roughly we can say the students, that is the side of this particular square will be 1 centimeter, right? The side of this particular red square, that is every side. As you know, students, square. What is the property of square, students? That is all sides are equal. All angles are also equal. There are many more properties also. But right now, as far as your standard is concerned, if you remember this two also, that is more important. All sides are equal and all angles are also equal. So whatever will be the side of this, the same will be of this, the same will be of the below one, and same will be for the left side also. So the all sides will be of 1 centimeter. So first question is measure the side of the red square on the dotted sheet. So here the side of the red square will be 1 centimeter. Next question is, students, draw here as many as rectangles as possible using 12 such squares. That means using 12 squares we need to form a rectangle. Students, using 12 squares we need to form a rectangle. That means ऐसे जो है this kind of squares we have to use such 12 and we need to make one rectangle. So let's begin now, right? How many we can make, that will count later on. So see, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I can make here my one rectangle. Is it okay, student? This is my first rectangle, right? Then I can make here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That means this one. Is it okay? This is my second rectangle. Okay, students, now seen the second rectangle. Now move to the third rectangle. We can draw here one more. See here, we can draw one more. Right? But this one is not complete. So what we can do? We can draw here a line. So now it is complete. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You have to imagine that the lines are there in between. I mean, lines dikhana nahi, but you have to imagine that four lines are there. So one square has been built up. Right? Now, see students, so what else we can draw the rectangles? I can connect this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I can connect here. See, this is one square, second, third, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right? Now let's see another rectangle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This one also. This one is also okay. Right, students? Now moving to the one more rectangle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This one also. Right? And we got one more also. See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right, students? So, by connecting 12 squares, we have formed the rectangles. Now we will see, students, that how many rectangles we have drawn with the help of 12 squares. Now, so let's count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Once again, students, I'm showing you, right? 1, 2, if possible, I'll write the numbers also. This is 1, 2, this is third rectangle, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. Right, students? So you can be able to calculate that there are total seven rectangles we can be able to form with the help of 12 squares. With the help of 12 squares, we can be able to form seven rectangles. So here there's one question, students. Then how many rectangles could you make? So here we're writing seven. See, this is also a rectangle only. This is also a rectangle, but it is not made up of 12 squares, right? So this will not count, right? Sometimes students think ye bhi to rectangle is, this also needs to be added. No. This is a rectangle only, but not made up of 12 squares. Right, students? I hope you understood this much. Okay, students, now we are going to understand two concepts, right? Which is very important as far as this chapter is concerned. Alright. That is area and the perimeter, right? Area word we have heard from lot of people also. If someone asks you that in which area you are living, right, you must be saying that this is my area, this is not your area, so don't come it. So this kind of sentences you must have heard in your life, right? But what actually the area is, area, that if you see the definition of area, students, the area means the space occupied by any 2D object. 2D object means the object which have only two dimension, that means length and breadth, right? I will explain you what is length also, what is breadth also, right? So don't worry for it. So the 2D shapes, that means length and breadth. For example, your paper is there, right? A paper, single paper sheet is there, drawing sheet is there. So that is what, they are 2D objects because they have only two dimension, length and the breadth. Length, if you Hindi mein bole jaye usko, to bolte hai lambai. Aur breadth ko bolte hai chaurai, right? So, jisme sirf do hi ho, right? The one which contains only this two, length and breadth, they are called 2D dimensions object, or you can say 2D objects. And the one which contains three, that means length, breadth and height. So, they are being called as 3D objects, like your cube, cuboid, right? If you consider your textbook, your textbook shape is a cuboidal shape because it contains the height also, thickness also, right? So we here will be considering here the area definition as the space occupied by 2D object, right? Yahan pe hame sirf 2D objects hi padhna hai. We don't have to study the 3D objects. So 2D objects means the objects which have only length and breadth. So area word is only and only meant for 2D objects only. Area sirf kaun se objects ke liye hota hai, students? For length and breadth. Agar aap cube, cuboid, cone, cylinder, if you are taking all these objects, so they are not a part of 2D objects. Unke liye hum dusra word use karte hai, that is called the volume, right? So the area ka matlab the space occupied by any particular object, right? Jitna space occupy kar raha hai, usko bolte hai uska area. Now here we'll understand, student, that what actually the area is, right? For example, see, this is your area, this is your square, right? The portion which I have shaded, the portion, students, which I have shaded, so that portion is called the area, right? That means area is always being confined with the interior part. एरिया हमेशा जब भी बात करेंगे तब हमेशा इंटीरियर पार्ट में ही हम डिस्कस करेंगे. एरिया ऑलवेज लाइज इन द इंटीरियर पार्ट, राइट. इट डजंट हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ यू नो कनेक्शन विद द बाउंड्री, राइट. नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द पेरीमीटर, नाउ व्हाट द पेरीमीटर इज, राइट, आई विल शो यू हियर एंड देन यू कैन एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. सी द प्लेस वेयर आई एम डूइंग दिस ब्लैक मार्कर. Black boundary, right? So this boundary is what? This boundary is called the perimeter. That means if you add all the sides of the given figure, then you get the perimeter, students. Ab koi bhi figure ho, koi bhi figure, doesn't mean that square is there. You can have triangle also, right? You can have any 4-sided, 5-sided, 6-sided. उन जितने भी figures हैं, उन सब की जितने भी sides हैं, you just have the measurement of all those sides. Just add it, you will get the perimeter. Right, so perimeter is nothing but the boundary of the given figure. Boundary of the given figure, but yes, the figure should be closed. It should not be open, right, students? So area is always confined with the interior part, and perimeter is always confined with the exterior part, right? Okay, students. Now on the page number 34, there are still two questions which we need to address, right? First question is, which of these rectangles has the longest perimeter? That means these are 7 rectangles, students. Out of the 7 rectangles, which of the rectangle has the longest perimeter? Second one is, students, which of these rectangles has the smallest perimeter? That means we have to find the longest perimeter rectangle and the smallest perimeter rectangle. As I have already explained you the meaning of the perimeter, right? So we have to calculate the perimeter of all these rectangles first, then it is possible to say that which of the rectangle is the greatest, having the greatest perimeter, and which one of the rectangle having the smallest perimeter. Okay, so we'll begin with the first one only, students. We'll start with the just the numbers there, we'll follow that only. Okay, we have to consider one side as 1 centimeter, right, students. So jitne bhi two dots ke beech mein one side hai, so that will be a 1 centimeter. Is it okay? So let's begin now. I will be only using one particular rectangle and its perimeter, and then we can able to calculate the remaining also, right? So let's begin now. This is my first rectangle. This is 1. That means this part, once this side will be having 1 centimeter. So I have written 1. Then here also 1 1 1 1 1 1 here also 1, students, 1 1 1 1. Is it clear? So this is the total. Iska jo bhi total karenge, that is the same will be for the below one also, right? So again here also 1, because this side is also 1, this is also 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 count the total number of ones we have written, right? Jitna bhi one likha hai, that is equal to its perimeter, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. So I can say, students, the first figure, that means the first rectangle, the perimeter is 26. So this one is actually 26. So I'm here in bracket, I'm writing 26. Right? Now moving on to the student's second one, I think that will also have the same only, right? This will also have the same because this both are of the same only. So second one will also have the second 26, right? 26 hi hoga uska bhi. Moving on to the third one, see this one. Okay, see students, 1, 2. Now I'm showing with my finger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So the perimeter of the third rectangle is, student, 16 centimeters. So in bracket I am writing, student, 16. Bracket mein isliye likha so that you don't have any confusion. Bracket means the perimeter value, right? Next one is 4. See, students, 4, 5, 6 and 7, they all will be having the same. So, ek ka calculate karenge, the remaining 3 will be of the same only. So, let's calculate the fourth one. See, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Now we have to answer that which of the rectangle has the longest perimeter. So longest means this one, the figure number 1, right? And the smallest perimeter means this one, right? Write it. We cannot write here that rectangle 1, rectangle 4, but we have to write it in a specific format. The specific format is, students, that is length into breadth. The specific format is, students, L multiplied by B. Here also L multiplied by B. So L means length and B means breadth. L means length and B means breadth. Length matlab lambai or breadth matlab chaurai, right? So first we'll see this shortest perimeter, right? And you can be able to calculate then for the first one also. Okay. If you talk about the length, students, so this is the length. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Ye uska lambai hua. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is your 4, so my length is 4 and my breadth, okay, what is my breadth? Breadth matlab chaurai kitna hai? 1, 2, 3. So this is my breadth, so here I am writing the value of breadth as 3, right? So 4 by 3 rectangle is having the smallest perimeter. Now students will calculate for the longest perimeter. Okay, what will the length? So this is my length. Right? So at the place of length, this is, I will write it here as 1. Dekho, ye uska lambai hai, 1 centimeter. Now what about the breadth? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So my breadth is 12. So whenever we write, students, here the answer for the rectangle, we need to write it in the specific format, that is length into breadth. I hope, students, you will be able to do this kind of sums by yourself.